I was going through my maps the other day when I noticed this. I didn't add it here, but somehow it's here. I've been looking for apartments in Paris and I've added a lot of phone numbers onto my contacts lately. That's probably where it comes from. So there's already something fishy about the icon, you know. Normally on Google Maps you have either a heart or a star or like a flag that when you add place. I spoke about this in one of those earlier videos, you can check it out right here. But in this one there's like a contact thing, you know, and that's like a clue, a blue clue. Blues. Did you guys watch Blue's Clues? And we can do anything. I just moved here yesterday and when I was looking for an apartment, I called so many people trying to organize a visit so that I can come and see the apartment. So on a website, when I found a phone number, I would just go to Google Contacts. You know how to do that, right? Something.something.com. Product.google.com. In this case, it's contact, so contacts.google.com. So let's just fire it up on Google Chrome. I'd hit create new, then I'd add in their name, their phone number and their address. So the contacts I'm adding here are temporary, right? So the idea is to add them onto my Google account directly from my computer. But I want to access these contacts and their addresses from my phone when I get to Paris. I don't ever have to go back to the website where I found these contacts in the first place or to Google Keep where I might have pasted them. I can either open the contact card. You do that by opening the phone app and looking for the contact and hitting the contact logo up top. Directions to their address easily. Conversely, if I received an SMS from this person, then I would just open up the contact by hitting the name of the person. To make this easier for me, I added all these contacts with a C-O-L-O-C in the end, which is a French short for colocation, which means house sharing. Pretty neat, eh? Well, you can technically go to Google Maps and actually add this place like we've discussed in that other video. I like this method better because once I found my house and all the other 5 phone numbers are redundant, I just look for C-O-L-O-C, delete all the phone numbers, and it's gone from my maps. There's this group of kids that are watching me and it's getting me like super conscious. I can't seem to concentrate. That's pretty much it for this video actually. I just wanted to show you guys how well these guys integrate. I added the maps address on Google Contacts on my computer and I used it on Google Maps on my phone and it just worked seamlessly. That's exactly the point of this video. The intro of this video that you guys saw was the last thing I shot in Lille. So I've moved to Paris and it's also exciting and it's also new because I'm gonna earn some money and pay back some of my debt. But I'm really grateful for Lille because this habit that I have built of making one video per week happened in Lille. I learned to use my drone in Lille and I learned to use my camera better to make better videos, consistent work in Lille. All of that stuff happened alongside school in Lille. So I'm so grateful. I've always wanted to make these videos, but before I moved over to Lille, I didn't have a vision, I didn't have a plan. And now I do. Let me know what you think about this. Did you already know this or was this brand new for you? If it was, then leave me a like. If it wasn't and you already knew it, then tell me how you learned about it in the comment section below. I'll hang around there and I'll respond to your comments. Thank you for tuning in and watching this video. I'll see you guys next week or maybe the one after that because I need some time to settle in. Until that time, you guys take care of yourselves and keep learning.